In this video, we're going to finish the multi-step trig problems worksheet on the KutaSoftware website under the geometry section, picking up with number 9. Now, remember, we're finding the area and we're rounding all intermediate values and our final answer to the nearest tenth. So we're going to need to figure out what the base is equal to and what the height is equal to. The height is represented by this blue dashed line. We'll call this h. And our base is going to be the portion of this right triangle plus the portion of the other right triangle. So let's call this x and y. So our base is x plus y. So number 9, we need to solve for our height, and we need to solve for x, and we also need to solve for y. So if this angle is 60 degrees, our height is opposite that angle, and we're also given the hypotenuse of 20. So using opposite and hypotenuse, think so. So we're going to be using sine. The sine of 60 degrees equals our opposite, which is h, over the hypotenuse of 20. What we're going to do is multiply both sides by 20 in order to cancel out the 20 on the right-hand side. So h equals 20 times the sine of 60, which is 17.32, which will round to 17.3. So now we have our height of 17.3. We still need to solve for the base. And remember, base is x plus y, so let's solve for x. Now, just as the height was the opposite side of 60 degrees, x is the adjacent side. So now, think C-A-H, adjacent over hypotenuse. So the cosine of 60 degrees equals x over our hypotenuse of 20, still looking at this right triangle on the left. Again, we're going to multiply both sides by 20 in order to isolate our variable, which in this case is x. And 20 times the cosine of 60 is 10. So 10 is equal to x. So now we have that our base is x plus y, which is 10 plus y. So our last variable we'll need to solve for is y. And we'll solve for y using our height of 17.3. This angle of 68 degrees, y is opposite that, and the height is adjacent to that. So think TOA, T-O-A, tangent of 68 degrees is going to equal the opposite side, y, over the adjacent side, the height of 17.3. Multiplying both sides by 17.3 will help us isolate our variable. So 17.3 times the tangent of 68 equals 42.81, which rounds to 42.8. Now that we know y, we'll plug that in for the base. So the base is 10 plus y, or 10 plus 42.8, which equals 52.8. Now we'll solve for our area. Area equals 1/2 the base times the height. So that's 1/2 of 52.8 times 17.3. Entering that into our calculators, 0.5 times 52.8 times 17.3, we'll get 456.72, which rounds to 456.7. So our area in number 9 is 456.7. Now again, in number 10, we need to solve for the base, and we need to solve for the height in order to calculate our area. Our height will be h, and our base, x plus y. Let's solve for h at the start. We have this angle of 30 degrees, and h is adjacent to that angle, and we're also given the hypotenuse of 33. So if h is adjacent, and we also have the hypotenuse, a and h, think ka or cosine. So we're going to be using cosine of 30 degrees equal to our adjacent side, h, over the hypotenuse of 33. Multiplying both sides by 33 will isolate that h. So 33 times the cosine of 30, h, is equal to 28.57, which rounds to 28.6. So our height is 28.6. So now we just need to calculate the base. And we'll start by calculating x, which is a portion of the base. So note that since h was the adjacent side of that 30-degree angle, x is the opposite side. So we're going to use the sine of 30 degrees equals opposite x over the hypotenuse of 33. Again, multiplying both sides by 33, we'll isolate that variable, which for the sine will be our variable x. 33 times the sine of 30 is 16.5. So 16.5 is x. So now, as opposed to the base equaling x plus y, the base equals 16.5 plus y. So we just need to solve for y. And we can use the fact that our height is opposite 42 degrees and y is adjacent to 42 degrees. So opposite over adjacent, think tangent. So the tangent of 42 degrees equals our opposite side, which is our height, of 28.6 over our adjacent side, y. We'll multiply y to both sides in order to get the y out of the denominator. So y times the tangent of 42 degrees equals 28.6. Our next step will be to divide by the tangent of 42 degrees. 28.6 divided by the tangent of 42 is 31.76, which rounds to 31.8. So now we have that our base is 16.5 plus 31.8. And 16.5 plus 31.8 equals 48.3. So area is 1/2 the base times the height. Our base is 48.3 and our height is 28.6. Entering those three numbers using multiplication on our calculator, 1/2 times 48.3 times 28.6 equals 690.69, which rounds to 690.7. 690 7/10 is our area in number 10. We're still solving for area, so we have to calculate the base and the height. However, we're not given a diagram where height is included, so we're going to have to draw height in. And the height is going to be perpendicular to our base. So this new blue line is h, and our base is going to be x plus y. So h is our height, and our base is x plus y. Let's start by solving for h. We're given that this angle is 70 degrees, and since we have a right triangle, since the height is perpendicular, we're going to be able to use a trig function. Our height is opposite 70 degrees, and the other piece of this is our adjacent side, x. So the tangent of 70 degrees equals h over x. However, we need to solve for h in order to solve for x. So let's look at this other right triangle on the left-hand side and solve for h. Remember, this total angle was 68 degrees, although when we drew our height, we could split that up into two separate angles. So using our triangle sum theorem, we know that 180 degrees minus 70 degrees plus 90 degrees will equal a portion of that 68 degree angle. 180 minus 70 plus 90 is 180 minus 160, which is 20 degrees. So this is 20 degrees. And if that angle is 20 degrees and the total angle was 68 degrees, we'll take 68 degrees and subtract 20 degrees to get this angle is 48 degrees. So if we have this angle of 48 degrees, our hypotenuse for this right triangle on the left is 37, and h is that adjacent side. So think cosine. Cosine of 48 degrees equals our adjacent side h over our hypotenuse of 37. Multiplying both sides by 37, I'll get that h is equal to 37 times the cosine of 48, which is 24.75, which rounds to 24.8. So we have our height, h, is equal to 24.8. So now we can plug our height of 24.8 in for the equation with tangent and solve for x. So the tangent of 70 degrees equals our height of 24.8 over x. Multiplying x to both sides, my x will be removed from the denominator. So x times the tangent of 70 degrees equals 24.8. So now I'll have to divide the tangent of 70 degrees from both sides. That'll leave me with x equal to 24.8 divided by the tangent of 70, which is 9.02, which rounds to 9.0. So our height h is 24.8, and our base, x plus y, is now 9 plus y. So we still need to solve for y in order to have everything we need to solve for the area. Now, how h was adjacent to 48 degrees, y is opposite 48 degrees. So as opposed to using cosine, we can now use sine. So the sine of that 48 degree angle is equal to the opposite side length y over our hypotenuse of 37. So multiplying both sides by 37 will help me isolate y. So 37 times the sine of 48 degrees equals 27.49, which rounds to 27.5. So now the base is equal to 9 plus 27.5, which the base is equal to 36.5, or 36 5/10. Now for area, if area equals 1/2 the base times the height, area will equal 1/2 of 36.5 times the height of 24.8, which is equal to 452.6. So our area in number 11 is 452 6/10. And lastly, on this worksheet, number 12. Remember, for area, we need to solve for the base, and we need to solve for the height. So our height is going to be h, this line that's perpendicular to the base. And our base is going to be this value x plus this value y. Now, notice this right triangle on our left-hand side is a 45-45-90 triangle. So that means that x is going to be congruent to h. So since x is congruent to h, that means that x is equal to h. So once we solve for one of those, we will know the other. We're also given that our hypotenuse is 44. So let's solve for x. X is adjacent to that angle of 45 degrees. So the cosine of 45 degrees equals x, our adjacent side, over our hypotenuse of 44. So what we're doing is multiplying 44 to both sides in order to isolate our variable. So x is going to be equal to 44 times the cosine of 45. And that is 31.11, which rounds to 31.1. So base is now equal to 31.1 plus y. And since this is 45-45-90, again, x is congruent to h, so h is also 31.1. So now all we have left to do is to solve for y. We have that this angle is 66 degrees, and y is adjacent to 66 degrees, and opposite that is h. So we're going to be using the tangent. The tangent of 66 degrees equals the opposite side h, which we know is 31.1, over the adjacent side y. We'll multiply both sides by y to get y out of the denominator. So y times the tangent of 66 degrees equals 31.1. Next, I'll divide by the tangent of 66 degrees. And doing that, I'll get that y is equal to 31.1 divided by the tangent of 66, which is approximately 13.8, since 13.84 rounds to 13.8. So now that I know y, I can plug that in for my equation and my base. 31.1 plus 13.8. My base is going to be equal to 44.9. Now that I know my base and my height, I can use my area formula. Area equals 1/2 the base of 44.9 times the height of 31.1. Typing that into my calculator, I'll get 698.19, which, when rounded, is 698.2. 698.2 is my final solution on this worksheet. If you have any questions, leave them in the comments below. And as always, like, subscribe, and share. All likes and subscriptions are greatly appreciated.